Welcome to a lesson on geometric series. The goal of this video is to determine the partial sum of a geometric series. Summing or adding the terms of a geometric sequence creates what is called a series. So here we have a geometric sequence, and here we have a geometric series. Notice a sequence is a list, and a series is a sum. The partial sum of the first nth terms of a geometric series is given by this formula. S sub n is equal to a sub 1 times the quantity 1 minus r to the power of n divided by 1 minus r. Let's go and take a look at where this formula comes from. If we were to start with the following geometric series, as we see here, a sub 1 plus a sub 1 times r plus a sub 1 times r squared and so on, all the way out to a sub 1 times r to the power of n minus 1. If we take this first equation and multiply both sides of the equation by r, we would have r times s is equal to, and each of these terms picks up an extra factor of r. So now the first term is a sub 1 times r, and the last term, instead of a sub 1 times r to the n minus 1, would be a sub 1 times r to the power of n. Next, what we're going to do is subtract these two equations. We're going to have s sub n minus r times s sub n. And if we do this, most of the terms will simplify out. For example, here we'd have a sub 1 times r minus a sub 1 times r, a sub 1 times r squared minus a sub 1 r squared, and so on, all the way out to the end, where we'd be left with a sub 1 times r to the power of n. So this difference will be equal to a sub 1 minus a sub 1 r to the power of n. Now if we take the left side of the equation and factor out the common factor of s sub n, we'd have s sub n times the quantity 1 minus r equals a sub 1 minus a sub 1 r to the power of n. Now we could divide both sides of the equation by 1 minus r. And now there's only one more step. If we factor out a sub 1 in the numerator, we would have a sub 1 times the quantity 1 minus r to the power of n, all divided by 1 minus r. And this is the formula we'll use to find the partial sum of a geometric series. Let's go and take a look at a couple examples. Here we have a geometric series. The formula that we're going to use is listed here. We'll have s sub n, or the sum of the first n terms, is equal to a sub 1 times 1 minus r to the power of n divided by 1 minus r. So we need to find a sub 1, r, and n before we can use this formula. Well, a sub 1 is the first term, which is 3. We can determine r by using the formula here, where we select any term in the series and divide by the term before it. So if we use a sub 2, we would divide by a sub 1. 6 divided by 3 is equal to 2, so r is equal to 2. And now we have to determine n, which would be the number of terms in this series. And we can use this formula here from our studies of a geometric sequence to determine n. If we let a sub n equal the last term, this n here will represent the number of terms in the series. So a sub n is equal to a sub 1 times r to the power of n minus 1. So a sub n is going to equal 1,536. A sub 1 is equal to 3. R is equal to 2. And we have to the power of n minus 1. We need to solve this equation for n, so let's divide both sides by 3. This will give us 512 on the left and 2 to the power of n minus 1 on the right. Now 512 can be written as a power of 2. It's actually 2 raised to the power of 9. So from that we can draw the conclusion that 9 must equal n minus 1. So if we add 1 to both sides of the equation, we know that n must equal 10. This is all the information we need to use this partial sum formula, so let's go ahead and see if we can answer the question now. The sum of the first 10 terms will be equal to 3 times 1 minus r to the power of n, or 2 to the 10th, divided by 1 minus r, which is, again, equal to 2. Let's go ahead and go to our calculator and see if we can determine this partial sum. Let's take a look at the numerator first. We're going to have 3 times the quantity 1 minus 2 to the power of 10. There's our numerator, and we're going to divide by 1 minus 2, which of course is negative 1. So we have 3069 for this partial sum. Let's go and take a look at another example. On this problem, we have the formula that will generate the terms in the series, and we also know there will be 5 terms because n is equal to 5. So again, let's write out our formula. We want the sum of the first 5 terms because we know n is 5. So to find the first term, we're going to have to use this formula. A sub 1 is equal to 2 times negative 3 raised to the power of n minus 1. Well, if n is 1, 1 minus 1 would be 0. Negative 3 to the 0 power is 1, so we have 2 times 1, or 2. Now, we do have to find r. If we can't look at this formula here and see what r would be, we would have to find one more term so we could use this formula here to determine r. Let's assume we can't determine r by looking at the formula. Let's go ahead and find the second term. So we'd have 2 times negative 3 to the power of 2 minus 1, or to the first power. Negative 3 to the first is negative 3 times 2, that's negative 6. So r would be equal to the second term divided by the first term, or negative 6 divided by 2, which is equal to negative 3. And again, based upon your experience, you may have been able to see that in the formula here. It's the base. And we're also given that n is equal to 5. That should be all the information we need. Let's go ahead and see if we can find this partial sum. Sum of the first 5 terms will be equal to a sub 1, which is 2, times 1 minus r raised to the power of n, all divided by 1 minus r. We do have to be a little bit careful about the signs here. Let's go ahead and go to our calculator. Let's take a look at the numerator first. We have 2 times the quantity 1 minus negative 3 power of 5. There's our numerator. And we're going to divide this by, it looks like, 1 minus negative 3, which would be 4. We have a partial sum of 122. Okay, that's going to do it for this video. I hope you found it helpful. Thank you for watching.